So if you have a six unit, let's use that as the example. There's probably not an exact six unit down the street that you can roll with. How are you actually getting to the after repair value on these smaller multifamilies? Is it strictly the commercial NOI over the cap rate? Are they taking comps? And if they do take comps, how do you compare like a six unit to a 10 unit and make those credits or adjustments?
That's a great question. The last part of that question is a little tough. I'll come back to that at the end. So we use three pieces of information. We use NOI, right? Because that drives cap rate. Then we use comparable sales, because six flats are actually is a decent amount of comparable sales data out there. If you don't have access to CoStar, which most investors do not, six flats trade and are listed on, Zillow, on the MLS. So there's actually decent comparable sales data out there on those. And then the last thing we look at is price per door. And this is maybe a term, this is a term that maybe not many people know about, but it's a benchmark that we as real estate investors always look at, because you've got to think about what the individual value of an apartment unit would be, because when it gets mixed into a six flat, maybe absorption of losses can happen across the six units, but you have to be able to isolate what the individual value of a unit would be, so that, if you have an experience, a vacancy experience, or if you have a significant CapEx experience, is that individual unit price so significant that you bought into that you could never get out of something like that? So those are the three elements that we look at when we value a building at its, call it terminal value or stabilized.